I've been a massive Far Cry fan for almost a decade now. Far Cry 3 is a great game. Far Cry 4 is a great game. Far Cry Primal is a bit different, but it's an alright game. Far Cry 5 is a good game. Far Cry New Dawn probably should have been DLC, but now here we are with Far Cry 6. And I just don't think I can do this anymore. I want to make two things clear from the outset. The first is that I do not enjoy being negative. If you look at my channel, you see it's mostly a positive channel where we celebrate video games rather than bring them down. The second thing I want to make clear is that I really, really did not like this game at all. I'm not going to sit here for 5 to 6 minutes or whatever and tell you why this game is the same as the rest and that it's time for a change. I'm going to sit here for 5 to 6 minutes or whatever and tell you that I think this game is worse than the rest. I think this is a bad game. This is the least fun I've ever had with a Far Cry title. And that saddens me because I am a fan. If you disagree with me, then that's cool. All I ask is that you stick around and hear me out. But if you don't want to hear an opposing viewpoint, then that's cool too. I'm glad you enjoyed the game. I didn't. And here's why. One thing Far Cry has always excelled at is its villains. No, I'm not going to say characters. Far Cry has never excelled at characters. It's excelled only with its villains. None of the protagonists have ever been even remotely interesting. Vaas was brilliant. He's iconic. Pagan Min was arguably even more layered. Joseph Seed was intimidating, and the sisters were, well, they weren't great, but they did the job. Anton Castillo is without a doubt the most boring villain I can remember this series ever having. There's absolutely nothing to him. And that's not the fault of Giancarlo Esposito. I feel like he tried his best with just a terrible role, and that's not particularly fair on him. But also, you almost never see him. You see him in person at the start and at the end. Other than that, it's just cutscenes where you see him, but it's not your character seeing him. It's just you, the player, seeing him. Think about Vaas. His most memorable moments are where he has you captured. The power dynamic is shifted so distinctly against you that his insane ramblings mean something. Castillo just talks in a methodic tone and never interacts with you. How are we supposed to feel this connection? There's nothing there. Speaking of a lack of connection, Dani is so boring. I could not care less about her. What even is her personality traits? She's a guerrilla. That's it. And this is a constant theme throughout this game. Ubisoft aren't even trying to write interesting characters anymore. There aren't any interesting characters in this game. Except Chorizo. He's adorable. Every other character kind of just morphs into one. They're all the same. You could strip dialogue from one character and give it to almost any other character in the game, and it wouldn't make a shred of difference. You would not notice. You can say you don't play Far Cry games for the story. Whatever. This series has always had somewhat interesting stories to tell, and that's completely gone here. It also seems that Ubisoft care even less about the mission design as I do about the characters they've created, because it's just rinse and repeat for 56 missions. Okay, yes. It's Ubisoft. You know what you're getting before you buy. I get that. But it seems like in the last year or so, they're trying to push the boundary of how far they can pad out their games. Assassin's Creed Valhalla was, no joke, 40 hours longer than it needed to be. But I like my games really long and I like to get a lot of content. What's the point of the content if it's not good? Assassin's Creed Valhalla, Watch Dogs Legion and Far Cry 6 all have one thing in common. After playing them for 2 hours, you have seen absolutely everything that they are going to offer you. Far Cry 6 is around 25-ish hours for its main story alone, and yet, if you've played it 2 hours of the game, then you've seen it all. The game isn't going to show you anything else. Every mission plays out the exact same way. Go to the marker, shoot the bad guys, pick up an item and then leave. It's predictable, it's lazy, and quite frankly, I've had enough now. Say what you want about Far Cry 5's terrible mission design, where you just do side missions until you're captured, but this is the same, just without the capture. Every main mission is side mission quality. I can't believe people think this kind of thing is acceptable in 2021, even though this video is coming out in 2022. Every single mechanic in this game has been designed with the sole purpose of wasting your time, of trying to squeeze every extra second of playtime out of you that they can. Instead of just going to a mission marker, most missions require you to go onto a yellow box on the map before walking around the box in a search zone until you find out where to go. Or sometimes they'll give you a picture on your phone and you'll have to go to the general area and then try and locate where the picture is. Remember the cool flamethrower mission from Far Cry 3? Well, that's it too, except you run out of it. You run out of fire for your flamethrower a quarter of the way through and have to get more, and then you can do the rest. Whenever you have to follow a character, they will walk slower than any human in real life ever would, just to squeeze out every single second they can. For some reason as well, sometimes you can't call your vehicle onto dirt roads. Sometimes you can, but sometimes you can't. You have to get back on tarmac sometimes, because whoever is delivering your car has a fear of mud. This game decides to throw all pacing out of the window just so that it can waste your time as much as it can. The gunplay is the only thing this game does right, and it's completely wasted in a game as dull as this one. Infiltrating a base with your suppressed weapon is honestly just as fun as it's ever been. All-out combat is as wild as it's ever been. That stuff hasn't changed, and it's the only compliment I will give this game. Although, they did try their best to ruin it with the new ammo system. Now you need certain ammo types to take out certain enemies. What the fuck were they thinking? It doesn't even add another layer to the game. Just bring a gun with armor-piercing rounds, and a gun with ballistic rounds, and you're sorted. And they got rid of the skill tree for some shitty clothing system. I wonder why they did that. Oh, you can buy clothing items with better stats in the store. Oh, well, there you go. They tried their best to destroy the only thing they had done well. The game world isn't even interesting. It's like they thought, people are becoming tired of Far Cry. The problem must be the setting. Let's go back to the tropical island of 3. I'm infuriated by their lack of care with this series. It's a money machine that they aren't even trying to preserve. They know that morons like me and you will just keep buying it anyway. I bet there were actually some people who thought, oh, yes, it's back on an island, I'll be picking that one up. And I just don't see it. I bought Far Cry 6 because I like Far Cry. Even its weaker entries like New Dawn, I enjoyed. Far Cry 6 is a gigantic step backwards on almost every single parameter. I disagree with the viewpoint of, it's just more Far Cry, because I don't think it is more Far Cry. I think it's Far Cry, but worse. You could make the argument that I'm just burnt out, but it's been almost 3 years since Far Cry New Dawn released. If I feel burnt out on a game that released 3 years since its last installment, I think that says more about the outdated formula than it does about me. I take no joy in saying any of this, but Far Cry 6 is a bad video game. It's not more of the same, it's worse than the same. It's a new low point for the series. I would rather play Far Cry New Dawn 5 times than play through this game again. At least then you had that weird saw gun thing, that was fun as hell. And the world looked actually really cool with the little graffiti colours and stuff. This is just a tropical island, no matter where you go. The map is absolutely huge, but there's no way to know what part of the map you're in unless you check, because it all looks the same. I will not be buying Far Cry 7 unless I see enough evidence to realistically suggest that Ubisoft are learning their lesson. But I'm not holding my breath. Thank you for making it to the end of this very negative video. It's been a bit ranty, hasn't it? I apologise. Most videos aren't usually like that, and if you don't believe me, then you might as well subscribe and take a look at some of the other positive videos where I celebrate games. But for now, that's all from me. If you enjoyed the video, then please make sure to leave a like, as it would be greatly appreciated by me. And if you did enjoy Far Cry 6, then please tell me in the comments, and please tell me why, so we can have a civilized discussion. But yeah, that's all from me. Have a nice day, and goodbye.